Today, Group 4 is going to present to you the case on Atok Refinery Limited and what changes they should bring about in the performance management system. The ratings are subjective in the sense that the appraiser's perception of the employee's performance solely determines the rating. The discrepancy in perceptions brings ineffectiveness into the process. Some targets are poorly defined and do not fulfill the SMART criteria. The competencies need to be explained to the employees so that they understand clearly what needs to be done to improve themselves. During the appraisal process, it is evident that some biases have crept into the system, which is resulting in the employees getting ratings which are more or less similar. Different departments should have different benchmarks when it came to the competencies. The reward should be linked to the performances of the employees.
Targets should be reviewed and revised by managers well before the start of the appraisal cycle. In our opinion, the weighting should not be changed. However, there should be a clear definition of what is the desired behavior attributed to each competency of employees in different roles. This can be done using the BARS method, where for each role and each competency, what is expected is clearly defined and distributed over a scale of 1 to 5. Employees should be given rating based on expressed behavior so as to avoid every employee getting a similar rating, and high performance will stand out.
Thank you, Parvati. The employees at ERL are frustrated because of low increments. Ideally, the increments of the employees should increase with inflation. Inflation is a general rise in the price level in an economy over a period of time. Hence, with the increasing rate of inflation, the purchasing power of the employees decreases, which demotivates them to work. An increase in increments will motivate the employees to work harder towards their goals and the overall goals of the organization. Hence, the increments of the employees at ERL should increase with the increase in rate of inflation. Now, I would like Ramakrishna to take it from here.
The main purpose of performance appraisal system is to reward the talent and motivate them to learn, work hard, and innovate in their jobs. But at ARL, due to central tendency bias in performance rating, most of the employees are rated equally and yearly increments are similar for all. This demotivates the star performers in the organization. So we recommend for a system where increments and other rewards benchmark to the performance appraisal system. A scale of overall performance rating to percentage of increment must be developed to promote the performance-oriented culture in our.
To improve performance management system, we would like to introduce monthly performance management software, which has been also been used by many organizations like Deloitte, Microsoft, etc. The process will include frequent check-ins, which is one-to-one meetings between the manager and the employee, where they discuss progress against the existing objectives, personal development, priorities, agree action points, issues, and new objectives where they have to add. This will also help HR to have visibility on how check-ins are taken place across the organization and how frequently feedback has been given. Then to collate performance and talent data without having to carry out formal performance appraisal. Further points will be discussed by Pavi.
In order to address the issue of back calculations in behavioral ratings and biases towards older subordinates, a 360-degree feedback system should be brought into practice. By performing regression analysis, the bias in Form B can be eliminated. Confidentiality should be maintained while rating each employee. Form A and B should be rated by separate individuals to avoid back calculations. This will make the ratings more reliable and identify the areas of improvement for each employee.
The success of the performance management system depends on the top management's willingness to embrace the change, therefore it is crucial to gain their acceptance. Initially, there could be a resistance from the employees as the changes in the model, like inclusion of bell curve, could make the employees concerned as they're unaware of how the changes will affect them in the workplace. So the reformed PMS should be implemented in a calibrated manner where the employees and managers should be made to understand the benefits and advantages and how it will support the rewards and development.
The next suggestion would be different departments having different competencies. As the expected objectives or tasks to be performed for each department is not the same. So there should be some clear-cut competencies assigned to people with respect to departments they belong. Competencies should be mapped in accordance to the department the employees assigned. These competencies department-wise will be directly linked to the strategic goals and objectives of the organization, which will result in a better understanding of what exactly is expected from a particular employee.
To foster a performance-oriented culture, clarity should be brought regarding target setting and competencies rather than altering the current weights. Performance of different departments should be assessed differently depending upon the task and role performed by each department. Rewards and recognition for the top performers must be upgraded and linked to the appraisal system so as to motivate the best performers and differentiate them from employees with low overall ratings. For the behavioral part, there was a lack of clarity on when and how to rate employees 1 and 4, resulting in similar ratings of 2 and 3. Hence, additional training sessions can be conducted to make matters clear in the mind of appraisers.
Live tracking of the learning and performance of employees. So this would be an app that every employee would have to download, and learning and performance are linked of each employee, and every manager would be monitoring their team's progress on a monthly basis. In learning, there would be an app where we could find out how users did their assignments or track attendance of events. And when it comes to performance tracking, as the learning concludes, each employee is assigned job tasks related to what they've learned through the training program. And efficiency calculation is the function of total hours available divided by the total hours at workstation allocated. So minute by minute calculation of such hours is now easily available using this solution. Thank you.